There's a 2010 SEBI circular that specifically lays down what a broker can or cannot do with a client power of attorney. Is this circular, strictly adhered to by brokerages, and what is the market practice around it?
So, Payaswini, the financial services industry is very highly regulated, and especially the brokerage business is highly regulated by SEBI, and clear rules have been laid down in terms of what the securities that are provided or bought on behalf of clients by brokers, what they can be used for. So the power of attorney also clearly lays down the broad parameters under which they can be used by the brokers on behalf of clients. There are enough and many regulations that clearly state that brokers cannot use clients' money or client securities for its own beneficial purposes, and it can only be either pledged or used for fulfilling clients' margin requirements or other payout requirements. And clearly, that is something that, given the importance, you're acting as a trusted advisor to your client. As far as we know, this is very strictly adhered to in the market. So the Carvey case really, came as a surprise to all of us.
I would agree with Pratibha, that is one. Number two, irrespective of the SEBI circulars, the law on the power of attorney between the stockbroker and the client is very clear. And there are enough number of judgments, not only today, but even if you go back 50 years, when the market was still developing, had not developed at all, yet there are judgments which clearly point out that, look, a stockbroker cannot abuse, cannot use, pursuant to the power of attorney, any of the client securities, any of the payments which is due to the client, or any such thing. The stockbroker has to absolutely work within a very, very strict and a limited framework. And therefore, clearly, Carvey has abused it wholesale, the power of attorney, which it was under an obligation not to abuse or not to even use it.
For every pledge that the brokerage does, do they need to seek a specific consent on that transaction, or does that power of attorney is all inclusive for all transactions whenever a margin requirement comes up?
So, Payaswini, you're right. It's a general power of attorney. Even if you have a brokerage account today, you don't need to go back and take client's consent each time. Basically, otherwise there wouldn't be a smooth running of the capital markets. What you allow the broker to do is operate your account how they deem fit under the SEBI regulations. SEBI regulations, what Sanjay is saying, is clear that whether you go by judgments or even the SEBI circulars in this regard are very clear. There are multiple circulars which specifically state you cannot use clients' money or securities for your own purposes. You've got to keep a clear demarcation between your money, your securities, and client money and client securities. However, the lender will not be able to know that this money is then being siphoned from client account to the personal account. The general power of attorney is something that is recognized both by the exchanges and SEBI, because that's the only way a brokerage house can also function, right? Because if I am allowing the brokerage house buy and sell securities on my behalf, yes, I open a margin settlement account. But if there are shortfalls, I have to ensure that there is settlement on T+1. So all that money moving has to be done by the broker on behalf of the client. Otherwise, you can't have an efficient securities market.
One is the securities laws. and the securities market, and the other one is the law of power of attorney. They're two different things. Merely because the regulator has made this power of attorney is not sufficient from a legal perspective. And there has to be something more, especially when you are lending large sums of money from pledging the shares from the pool account.